Hello everyone, in the previous video we have discussed about MRTS, marginal rate of technical substitution, right? Today in this video we are going to discuss about Cobb-Douglas production function and also about least cost combination of inputs. So Cobb-Douglas production function, you already know what is a production function. It is a mathematical function, you can say, that gives the relationship between your output and also input, right? Input factors, what are the contributing for output and how much output you are going to get. So this production function, which is given by Cobb and Douglas, is called as Cobb-Douglas production function. And the mathematical expression of this production function is y is equal to a k to the power of x l to the power of 1 minus x. Here y is nothing but output variable, the amount of output that you're going to get. And a is a positive constant and k is capital, l is labor, as you already know, and x stands for a variable that will change the value of y. According to the value of x, the value of y will be changing. That means according to the number of units of capital or labor taken, we will be choosing the x value, okay? And let us see what are the assumptions of this function. That means what are assumed before giving this production function, what are the points that these two economists have assumed, okay? So this Cobb-Douglas production function was given based on these five assumptions. The first one is output is a function of only two variables, and those two variables are your labor and capital. There will be many input factors like land and many things like organization, machinery, equipment and everything, but among all those, labor and capital are the main two variables that are going to determine your output. And next, it is a linear homogeneous function of degree one. This is of first degree equation, right? So that is why linear homogeneous function of degree one. All the inputs are homogeneous, that is nothing but if you are taking labor, all the labor that you are going to be taking should be homogeneous. That means the labor should be of same kind. And next, capital should also be of same kind. Like all the capital should be in the form of money, or all the capital should be in the form of some resources or whatever it is. But there should not be combination of one or more things. You should have all the input factors as same. The next one is no change in the technology. That means the technology will not be changed. If suppose you have machines and from machines you have got robots, but still they assume that the technology is not changed. Based on this assumption only, that production function is given. If there is change in technology, then this production function will not be applicable. The next one is perfect competition. What do you mean by perfect competition? Perfect competition means that the price of one commodity will be fixed and the entire market has to follow that price. You'll be learning about perfect competition and imperfect competition perfectly in the next videos, okay? So these are the assumptions of Cobb-Douglas production function, and the mathematical expression is y is equal to a k power x l power 1 minus x, where y is the output, a is constant, k capital, l is labor, and x is a variable that will be changing the value of y. Okay, these are the basic assumptions of Cobb-Douglas production function. I hope you are clear about it, and next let us learn about least cost combination of inputs. Okay, the next concept is least cost combination of inputs. In this concept, you'll be having minimum number of inputs, you'll be combining minimum number of inputs such a way that you'll be getting a maximum output. You'll be using a very less input, but you'll be generating a very huge output. That is the concept of least cost combination of input. How efficiently, how effectively you can combine inputs in such a way that you'll be getting maximum of the output. Okay, and the mathematical expression can be given by marginal product of labor by price of labor is equal to marginal product of the capital by price of the capital. I already said you what is marginal product or marginal price of a input factor in the previous video, in MRTS video, right? So in least cost combination of inputs, there is nothing you do. You'll just combine inputs in a very minimum ratio so that you'll be getting maximum outputs even though you combine very minimum amount of inputs. Okay, this is the graph of list cost combination of inputs. In this graph, you'll be clearly understanding about the concept. As usual, we'll be taking capital on the y-axis and labor on the x-axis for all the graphs. Even for ISO content, ISO cost curve also, we did the same, right? Here also, in this graph, you have to first plot the ISO cost curve. This is ISO cost curve, right? If you can remember, you'll have this video. In the previous videos, you can refer about ISO cost and ISO quant curves. So this is ISO cost. First, you have to draw the ISO cost curve, and on ISO cost curve, you're supposed to superimpose the ISO quant curve. ISO quant is nothing but same quantity of output irrespective of the inputs you take. ISO cost is same cost, right? So when you superimpose at a point where the ISO cost curve will act as a tangent to this ISO quant curve, is called as the equilibrium point, a tangent. See here, it is acting exactly like a tangent to this curve. So this is the point of equilibrium. At this particular point, you will be getting the least cost combination of inputs. That means you will be getting a more output at just least cost. Okay. This curve, this point is, I already said you, this point is called as equilibrium point. The point where ISO cost will act as a tangent to ISO quant curve is called as the equilibrium point, and also point of least cost. Okay, at this point you're going to obtain more output with least cost. Output is 300 units fixed, whether it is here or here, wherever it is, because it is an ISO quant curve, the quantity will be same. So the output is fixed. The only thing that is going to change is the cost. So at this point you'll be obtaining the equilibrium point. Okay. This is the concept of least cost combination of inputs, and also about the Cope-Douglas production function. This is a very small concept and a very simple concept. Okay.